His trusted companions deserted him, and his number one man denied him. So it was all story of betrayal, story of lies, story of dishonesty, meanness, unfaithfulness, and wicked violence directed against an innocent and apparently helpless victim. All this comes to get on plus today's Good Friday, when Jesus was first mocked, nailed on the cross, where he dies here to us. So that's the end. If this will be the end of the story, I think for all of us, this is really a bad story. This is a tragedy. But thanks be to God, it is not. Death is not the end of the story. Because there is one more chapter. There is one more chapter because the saying goes, they who love last, love best. And in this last chapter of the story of Jesus, we see him rise from the dead in all glory and majesty. He is vindicated. His enemies are shamed and confused. Jesus regains his eternal glory with the Father. He is the Lord who will prevail over all mankind and his enemies included. For us, his mother followers, this is the good news. This is the good news. And it is a good news to know that truth is immortal. We can suppress truth, accuse it of being lie, condemn it, torture it, kill it, bury it, and begin the grave, but on the third day, truth will rise again. Remember this, and then give up on the truth. Even when everybody seems to give up on it. Don't give up on truth, do not give up on justice, do not give up on doing what is right, because truth will always be true. Just will always be just, right will always be right, even when the world around us will tell you otherwise. We must learn to believe
the truth will set you
free. Even when it's not shining. Knowing that by and by,